Welcome to this review of the new Renault Zoe, the ZE50 model. Now, this is an electric vehicle which has been released since 2012, nearly a decade old electric vehicle. And Renault have sold 200,000 of the Renault Zoe over that lifespan, but get this, 100,000 of which were sold just last year in 2020. So if there's anyone out there who doesn't believe the EV ramp up is happening, and it's happening now, numbers like that speak for themselves. Now, this is the third generation Zoe. It has a 54 kilowatt battery, of which 52 are usable, despite the name ZE50. Another great thing about this car is that it gets you the most amount of range for the least amount of money. So even when you look at competitors with the same battery size, they get less range than this car. And the reason of which is all the tech that is happening underneath the bonnet and underneath the seats, for sure. So what is it in the tech of this car that is giving it the advantage over its rivals? Let's find out. The car is built as part of the Renault, Nissan and Mitsubishi alliance. It is a car which was built purely as an EV, so there are no diesel or petrol variants of this car. And because it's built as an EV, they've maximized the EV architecture as much as they could. For example, the battery is placed under the passenger compartment, as is commonplace nowadays. It does mean though that the car feels slightly higher than usual. However, as you can see, that doesn't impact your headroom in any way. The original battery pack of the first Renault Zoe was 22 kilowatt hours. In the second iteration of the Renault Zoe, they upgraded that to nearly double at 40 kilowatt hours. And when they did that upgrade, they kept the same physical dimension of the battery pack. For this, the third generation, they have a 54 kilowatt battery pack, of which 52 are actually usable. However, once again, the physical size of the battery pack in the car hasn't changed. And it is made up of 192 different cells, which are split into 12 modules each. The battery supplier is LG Chem, and they are using the LGX E78 batteries. These are flat batteries, they are not cylindrical batteries. And they are the same cells, the same exact cells you're going to find in the Volkswagen ID3, the Hyundai Kona, and the Chevrolet Bolt. The battery chemistry being used is NCM712, which means there are 7 parts nickel, 1 part cobalt, and 2 parts manganese. The cells are manufactured in Europe, in Poland, and then they are shipped to France, where they are assembled into the battery pack, which then is assembled into the vehicle. Renault take great pride that they make their own electric motor for the Renault Zoe. And that means they built not only the electromagnet, but they build the electrical controller and also the gear reducer, which sort of replaces the gearbox in a traditional car. The motor comes in 2 options for this latest version of the Zoe. The older Zoe had a 110 brake horsepower motor, which is still available as an option. However, in this, the highest spec version, you get a stronger and a newer motor, which has 135 brake horsepower. This equates to a 0 to 50 km per hour speed of 3.5 seconds. And 0 to 100 of 9.5 seconds. The car caps out at a top speed of 140 kilometers per hour. The Renault Zoe uses an air-cooled battery cooling system. So it is a cheaper system than the liquid-cooled found in some EVs, which is helping keep down the cost of this vehicle. The air cooling is being funneled through the air conditioning system. So the same air conditioning system is actually cooling the battery. It is an active system, which means it will turn on its own, particularly when the vehicle is being charged and when the vehicle is being used. The range is impacted by the air cooling system. So in climates where there are temperature changes which do affect the battery, and the cooling will need to turn on more frequently and thus impacting the overall range of the vehicle. This car does a WLTP of 395 kilometers in range, which is a very high number when you consider the 52 kilowatt battery available. It does outclass a lot of its competitors with the same battery size in this regard. The car has two regenerative braking modes. There is one which is always active in the normal driving mode. It is, I'd say, quite minimal, and it's definitely more minimal than the previous generation Zoe. However, the B mode, or the advanced regen mode, is actually quite a bit stronger than the previous Zoe, and you can essentially nearly drive your car on one pedal with that braking mode. The Renault Zoe comes with two charging options, a 22 kilowatts onboard AC charger and a rapid charging option of 50 kilowatt hours. Now, the AC charging, the 22, is actually one of the fastest you're going to find on any electric vehicle, even faster than a Tesla on AC charging. That means you can charge this battery on AC charging in around 3 hours. The DC fast charging is perhaps slower than most rival competitors at 50 kilowatt hours, but with this 50 kilowatt battery, it means you get a full charge in around 50 minutes. A lot of people are skeptical on how much the battery of electric vehicles is going to last. Of course, I am in a new car today, but the great news is that Zoe has a 10-year history, so we can definitely look back to see how these cars actually fare in the real world. And for this segment, I'm actually going to change the car I'm in. So we have transitioned into this ZE40 Renault Zoe, a car which is actually 4 years old and been on the road for 4 years. It is the previous generation Zoe from the one we were just in. This has 41,000 kilometers on the clock. It had a 40 kilowatt battery, which gave it a range of 300 kilometers. Now, the reason we're doing this segment is there are a lot of people who are skeptical on how these electric vehicles are going to perform in the long run. So this is a 4-year-old vehicle. It still easily achieves the 300 kilometers WLTP range it was sold at, despite having 41,000 kilometers on the clock, which is, you could say, normal for a small country like Malta. And so there's been no real impact on the battery, and when you talk about degradation, definitely not affecting the range. Further to that, over these 4 years, we actually saw more than WLTP on a number of occasions. So the range of your electric vehicle is going to fluctuate, particularly with the temperature, but also in the way you drive. And this car can easily achieve here in Malta 15, 20%, 25% more range than WLTP. I know that will make a lot of people in the northern countries like the UK, etc., quite jealous. But here in Malta, we're getting greater than WLTP most of the time. Thank you again. I hope you found this tech review useful. We are again in the Renault Zoe ZE50, the latest iteration of the Zoe. Shout out to Peter once again for helping me with all the technical going on. Shout out to my father for bringing his older version Renault Zoe to this review and sharing his expertise on the car over the past 4 years of use. If you're new here, thank you for watching. I have reviewed the Peugeot e208 as well previously. Feel free to check out that video. And if you're in Malta, you're interested in EVs, make sure you join our Facebook group, Electric Vehicles Malta Community, where we discuss EVs and talk about everything electric. Thanks for watching.